Get ready to match the stars. Dick Gautier, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Della Reese, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reilly.
Thank you for joining us here. Come over here and let's say hello to our celebrities. I greet you one and all. I would like you to note that the threesome is reunited again. Gautier, so Reilly, and Rayburn. Yeah. Listen, we haven't seen you in a long time. What have you been up to?
Oh, it's only been a couple. Only features. I'm only doing features now. I did a couple of movies. Yeah.
No kidding.
Listen, I don't want to be blatant about it because I don't believe people are on these shows to do plugs, Gene. I really think that people are only here to help contestants win and that sort of thing.
Billy Jack goes to Washington. Really?
Well, try and be a little less obvious.
What do you say we lay hello to champ Kathy Whitehead?
Great.
How are you?
Really good.
Good. Now, as time expired, Kathy won $100. She won the game. So that means she's going to try for over $5,000 now. You ready for that?
I sure am.
Yes. Now, tell us again when you're expecting your baby in a couple of months.
Yeah, October 4th.
Oh, October 4th.
Mm-hmm.
Really? Okay. Well, good luck to you, Kathy. We'll start with a big money audience match here in a moment or so, but right now we want to start up with this. Now, oh, we're ready. Here we are. Kathy, you're ready. Just stand right there on the adhesive tape. That's it. And we'll be get right to it. Kathy, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Bon blank, or bone blank, whatever it's, bon, B-O-N blank. Now, the answer that bunch gave most often, they had that written on a card in front of them, you see. The top answer is worth $500 if you match it, $250 if you match the middle one, and then $100 if you match the bottom one. Three of the six are permitted to assist.
Well, I'll go with Richard first.
Bon voyage!
Bon voyage!
And Brett?
What about bonbons?
Bonbon. Okay, another one.
Fannie?
I'm sorry, did you call on me?
Yes, you've been called on.
Just a little note, I forgot, something I forgot to tell before the show.
Bonnie and Clyde.
No, wait, you're only funning us, aren't you?
Bon Wit Teller.
Oh, of course,
what?
Bon Wit Teller.
Bon Wit Teller? Okay, so you got Bon Wit Teller. You got bonbon, and you got bon voyage. You want
one? Bon voyage.
Bon voyage is one that you want. All right, let's find out if there's one Richard gave you. Let's begin down at the bottom. As we usually do, and we'll reveal the $100 response. Bonfire.
Oh. Where were you when I needed you?
Let's see if bon voyage is under the $250 number.
Oh.
Bonbons. All right, that's the one that Brett gave you, right? No.
Direct?
Yeah.
No one gave you that. Yeah, that's right. Okay.
Sweet little girl that she is.
We're looking for, what did you say you want?
Bon voyage.
Bon voyage.
We're on Match Game.
Roger.
And it's the afternoon.
Roger.
You shouldn't have circled bonbon because it confuses me, you see. What she really wanted was bon voyage there. But I understand it now. You don't understand it. I just wanted you to understand it, Roger.
That's right.
Okay. He has a master's degree in...
Stupidity.
In cue cards.
In ignorance.
And here we go. Last chance for Bon Voyage. May we see the $500 number?
Yes!
Yeah. Yeah, congratulations. You got it. Don't jump around too much there. Are you allowed to jump?
Yes.
Oh, you can. Oh. I got a little nervous there. I said, are you allowed to jump? And she said, yes, she's allowed to jump. Don't mind a thing. She just won $500. That's why she's jumping around like that. Okay. Now, Kathy, you're going to play for 10 times of $500 or $5,000, but to collect that amount of money, you must match one of the celebrities exactly. Which one will it be?
It will be Bert. Richard!
Bert Parks.
Bert Richard.
I love you, Bert.
Sing Mr.
We don't have... There's no Bert on this show. What are you talking about? Bert is going to be the name of your son when he's born, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Well, she wants... I'm honored that you call me Bert.
Yes.
How don't did be, you get him mixed up with Bert Reynolds? He's much better looking than Bert Reynolds.
Just get ready. Get your ESP going over to this little lady so she can win some money here. Now stand on the tape and face me and I'll get the number. It's worth $5,000 and it reads as follows. Blank form. F-O-R-M. Blank form. Blank form. All right, now, Richard's ready. Kathy is thinking very hard. She's getting her ESP going over there, electrical energy to Richard Dawson, so she can articulate the same answer now that he's written on the card. What do you say?
The only thing I can think of is income tax form.
Income tax form. Oh. Well, what would you say? Oh, I see. No.
Maiden form?
That's what they're saying. All right, now her answer is...
Fannie wears maiden form.
We hope as little as possible. She says income tax form will match over the $5,000, Richard.
The ESP went with the audience. Maiden form.
Oh, maiden form.
I'm sorry, darling.
Aw. Well, Kathy, you've enriched yourself a little bit. You're up to $600, and you're going to meet another player now. And I know you're happy about that. Let's welcome Joseph May. There's Joseph Payne. Now you can get back up there as soon as it stops. Joseph, you know Kathy Whitehead there? And she's up to $600, which isn't bad at all. Joseph, we welcome you and ask you to tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm from Mount Carmel, Pennsylvania. I'm married. My wife's name is Gretchen. We're both hairstylists, and we have our own shop in Pennsylvania.
In Pennsylvania somewhere. Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, the best of luck to you. Who does your hair?
Myself and my wife.
Oh, I see.
I comb it in the morning and she does it.
I see. All right. Well, we'll start this game in a moment or so, but right now we want to start a little message for you. Pay attention and come right back. Here we go. Boing. Joseph May, you may have A or B.
B, please.
B it is. We're going to start this game right now. Are you ready to begin?
I am ready to begin.
Thank you, my dear. Ugly Edna said.
She's my favorite.
She said, if you think I'm ugly now... You should have seen me before I had my plastic surgery. Then I looked like blank. That's what Ugly Edna said. If you think I'm ugly now, you should have seen me before I had my plastic surgery. Then I looked like blank. We're going to see a lot of you on Chico and the Man.
I hope you're going to see a lot of me on Chico and the Man.
Yeah, well, we'll keep watching for you.
Keep being over there so you can see me, too.
Okay, good. All right, Charles is just about ready, so I'll walk over here to Mr. May and ask him to respond. Ugly Edna said, if you think I'm ugly now, you should have seen me before I had my plastic surgery. Then I looked like...
Frankenstein.
Frankenstein. All right. He said, then I look like Frankenstein.
That's an excellent idea, as a matter of fact, Joseph. Unfortunately, I said looks like Phyllis Diller.
Phyllis Diller. Phyllis Diller. She's the famous one. Kids herself about being ugly and all that, and then had the plastic surgery.
She had her face lifted in.
Oh, gosh,
she's as cute as the
bunny. And everything else, yes.
I said that she looked like a dog.
A dog, yeah.
What happens to me when Fannie does this show? I just start talking so southern.
Hi, hon. Hello, Charles.
Hi.
A dog.
All right. You should have seen me before I had my plastic surgery. Then I looked like Frankenstein, according to Joe.
I said King Kong.
King Kong. Very good. Fay Wray liked him, but...
They were very close.
Yes, they were.
I thought she looked like Howard Cosell.
Without his...
El Ruggo,
is yeah, without El Ruggo. All right, Miss Fannie, honey, welcome back.
Thank you.
I tell you the truth, I thought and thought, because the neighborhood I was raised in, we always said somebody was an ugly as a dog, you know?
That's what she said.
You're doing the switch here, there, you're talking like, okay, Joe, there you are. That's the way it goes, Joe. All right? So, no score there. Kathy, this is your first rounder.
And the, thank you.
There was something in there.
Oh, devil.
Oh, it's all gone now, Gene.
So, okay. Harvey the Undertaker used to be a magician. That's why whenever he gets a body, he doesn't bury it, he blanks it. Harvey the Undertaker used to be a magician. That's why whenever he gets a body, he doesn't bury it, he blanks it.
I got it.
That's an easy one.
Sure.
You want to look at this while you're writing there? Billy Jack goes to Boston.
Your mind is gone.
Yes, it is.
Once more, please.
He used to be a musician.
Oh, musician.
He's the operator.
No, not
musician. He said magician.
Magician.
Oh!
Oh, wow.
You can't see, you can't hear. You're impossible.
Don't you got a sweet little southern girl like that.
Harvey the Undertaker used to be a magician.
I get it, honey.
That's why whenever he gets a body, he doesn't bury it, he blanks it. That's good, now that you understand it.
See, it's a trick I learned early in life.
You have to work at your enunciation.
You don't get top billing.
Hey, wait a minute.
All right, everybody's ready over there. Kathy, you ready?
Here we go.
Charles, put it in the slot. Thank you, sir. Harvey the Undertaker used to be a magician. And that's why whenever he gets a body, he doesn't bury it, he blanks it.
Well, the only thing I can think of that they do with bodies is saw them in half.
She saws it in half. Yeah, okay, that's it, magician. One thing magicians do to bodies, saw it in half, right? What do you say?
I say that's a little gruesome of you, really. To saw a corpse in half is a wonderful image that I want to use. I said makes it disappear.
Makes it disappear? That's a good answer.
Sorry.
That's another thing magicians do. What'd you say, Brett?
I said, you said blanks it. I said makes it disappear it.
Makes it disappear it. That's okay. Charles?
I said makes it disappear like this. See that?
Oh, very good. Harvey the Undertaker used to be a magician. He doesn't bury a body. He blanks it.
Makes it disappear.
Makes it disappear.
That's what
that seems to be the answer. Although yours was a good answer, too, there. What'd you say, Rich? Wow.
Say abracadabra, Kathy.
Abracadabra.
Pardon? Sausage and hot.
Wonderful, Kathy. See? What do you say, Ollie?
That's right. I said sausage and hot.
Sausage and hot. Well, half a body is better than none. Joe, you want A or B this time?
I'll take B again, please.
B again. Okay, everybody plays. He didn't match anybody in the first round. Lester played a trick on his wife and switched her birth control pills with Bayer aspirin. 9 months later, she gave birth to a 6-pound blank.
Hi, hon.
Switched her birth control pills with Bayer aspirin. 9 months later, she gave birth to a 6-pound blank.
Okay, sweetheart.
All right. Okay. Okay. Well, isn't that neat? They all finished so quickly, Joe. Lester played a trick on his wife, switched her birth control pills with Bayer aspirin. 9 months later, she gave birth to a 6-pound...
I have to say headache.
Headache? That's a little joke between me and the staff over there.
He would say that?
No. What did you say?
I said a 6-pound
headache.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's good.
He just sounds like that machine there. What did you say?
Don't he make funny noises?
Yes, he do.
Well, that's what I said. Headache.
6-pound headache. What did you say, Charles?
Without showing posters of my movies or...
Let's say a headache. All right. He's up to 3 now. Della, Reese, he's rolling.
Well, he's up to 4 now.
All right. He's going to stop with her. Richard, looking for a 6-pound headache.
No, not today, Gina. I have a headache.
Fine for you. Fannie?
Well, let me tell you, I take this game literally. Now, when she found out what he'd done, see... She killed him, so she gave birth to an orphan.
That's right.
Is
now, very good, my dear. Now I will tell you what I was laughing about over there. Because, you see, I proofread these things just to make sure there are no typographical errors. And a couple hours ago when I was proofreading it, they said, everybody's going to say, switch your birth control pills with bear aspirin. 9 months later, she gave birth to a 6-pound bear. But nobody said it. There he is.
He's the one I said. You said bear aspirin, didn't you?
I said bear aspirin.
Yeah. Not
didn't
bear.
I say bear aspirin? No, I said bear aspirin.
Bear, yeah.
Right. Okay.
Well, we're not Southern.
Now, you're embarrassed. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to embarrass you, but you're fired. So at the end of, or the middle of round two, we got 5-2. When we come back from this commercial, you go to work and see how you can do right now. You pay attention to this. Okay, here we go. You know what you have to do, Kathy?
Sure do.
What do you have to do?
Have to get four.
Four and two or six, that's right. If you get four, you win the game. You can get three and tie, but
Gene,
four would be better.
You've got a mind like a steel trap.
Yes, sirree.
Really, it's chilling to watch it turn over.
Four.
The lady with child knew how many she needed.
You don't play this time.
Oh, all right, if you're going to punish me.
You ready, Della? You play.
I'm ready.
Everybody watches Happy Days, right? All right.
No.
Well, do I? Yes. Well, why, on one of those shows, funny says, hey, I got to get rid of Dolores. All she ever wants to do is grease my blank. Hey. Get rid of Dolores. All she ever wants to do is grease my blank. There.
Floozy.
Hey, you watch Happy Days, right? I gotta get rid of Dolores. All she ever wants to do is grease my blank.
What does Fonzie do?
Fonzie, you've never seen the show. You've never seen the show.
Shh.
Shh. Well, I'm sorry, you're on your own. I can't tell you any more than that. He's a star of the show, and it's called Happy Days.
I thought Ronnie Howard was the star.
I thought Tom Bosley was the star.
No.
Or whomever.
No,
I would like.
We've
to
just
know.
Changed all that. Just put something on the card so we can get on with it, and this will be a disaster for you. But those happen occasionally.
Oh, that's a wonderful answer.
All right.
I'm sitting down.
Now, Kathy, you'll watch Happy Days, right?
I never have watched it.
You've never watched Happy Days.
Can you believe that?
Okay. You could give me your answer without my even asking the question if you've never watched the show. But anyway, Fonzie, this fella, the character, you must say, says, hey, I gotta get rid of Dolores. Dolores, all she ever wants to do is grease my blank. Hey.
All she ever wants to do is grease my hair is the only thing I can think of.
Grease my hair. Not bad. He does have a big head of hair, and he's a little bit greasy. That might work for you. What'd you say, Dick?
Obviously, you've never seen the show. I mean, that is... I'm sorry, Kathy.
Well,
it's a dumb answer.
Hair.
I haven't seen it either. I said hair.
Score is now 5-3.
Well, I was totally up.
Here's another one who never saw the show.
I was totally up. I was completely confused and befuddled. So I said hair.
5-4, the score. Charles?
Oh... hair.
Oh, surprise, surprise. 5-5 the score. Now, here we go. We got a tie. Let's see if Della Reese reveals her answer and breaks the tie, or whether the game ends in a tie.
See,
what do you say?
I should have did something else, but I said motorbike.
Motorbike is a good answer.
Yeah?
Because he does ride a motorcycle. That would be the other thing. All he wants to do is grease my motorcycle. All right, 5-5. The game ends in a tie. We'll tell you what happens right after we tell you about this. I think we'll just leave all these numbers up here because we've got to stop right now. This game ends in a tie. We'll just have to pick it up. You'll have to come back next time, and we'll go to a tiebreaker and see how it turns out, okay?
Yeah.
Look forward to seeing you next time. Now, those of you who will be in the vicinity of Newport, Rhode Island, I mean Providence.
No, at the end of September.
At the end of September,
we'll
which
Memphis.
We are about the end of September now, aren't
yeah,
we, folks?
Memphis, yeah,
we
today, right. Madam Butterfly.
Madam,
two performances September 30th and October 2nd, Memphis Opera Theater. Well, I'm going to direct it, not be Madame Butterfly.
But you're doing one in Rhode Island, too, aren't you?
Well, yes, but that was done, I think, already. That's the 1st of September.
Oh, all right, it's all over.
Well, you look at the chart in the dressing room, everything comes clear.
And it'll be in your book. Okay. Well, I thank you,
thank
one and all.
You, for asking.
You were just splendid.
Well, thank
we'll
you.
And we'll look forward to seeing all of you next time. Now, I don't quite understand. What does that say? There's writing on there.
The jukebox doesn't make any selection. I just say goodbye.
Oh, all right. I'll make a selection while you say goodbye. $100. She won the game. So that means she's going to try for over $5,000 now. You ready for that?
I sure am.
Yes. Now, tell us again when you're expecting your baby in a couple of months. Is it
October 4th.
Oh, October 4th.
Mm-hmm.
Really? Okay. Well, good luck to you, Kathy. We'll start with a big money audience match here in a moment or so, but right now we want to start up with this. Now, oh, we're ready. Here we are. Kathy, you're ready. Just stand right there on the adhesive tape. That's it. And we'll be get right to it. Kathy, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Bon blank, or bone blank, whatever it's, bon, B-O-N blank. Now, the answer that bunch gave most often, they had that written on a card in front of them, you see. The top answer is worth $500 if you match it, $250 if you match the middle one, and then $100 if you match the bottom one. Three of the six are permitted to assist.
Well, I'll go with Richard first.
Bon voyage!
Bon voyage!
And Brett?
What about bonbons?
Bonbon. Okay, another one.
Fanny?
I'm sorry, did you call on me?
Yes, you've been called on.
Just a little nod. I forgot something I forgot to tell her before the show.
Bonnie and Clyde.
No, wait, you're only funning us, aren't you?
Bon Wit Teller.
Oh, of course.
What?
Bon Wit Teller.
Bon Wit Teller? Okay. So, you got Bon Wit Teller, you got Bon Bon, and you got Bon Voyage. You want me to...
It'll be Bert.
Richard!
Bert Parks.
Bert Richard.
I love you, Bert.
Sing Mr.
We don't have... There's no Bert on this show. What are you talking about? Bert is going to be the name of your son when he's born, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
I'm honored that you call me Bert.
Yes.
How did you get him mixed up with Bert Reynolds? He's much better looking than Bert Reynolds.
Bert. Just get ready. Get your ESP going over to this little lady so she can win some money here. Now stand on the tape and face me, and I'll get the number. It's worth $5,000, and it reads as follows. Blank form. F-O-R-M. Blank form. Blank form. All right, now Richard's ready. Kathy is thinking very hard. She's getting her ESP going over there, electrical energy to Richard Dawson, so she can articulate the same answer now that he's written on the card. What do you say?
The only thing I can think of is income tax form.
Income tax form. Oh. Well, what would you say? Oh, I see.
Oh, uniform?
No.
Maiden form?
That's what they're saying. All right, now her answer is...
Where's maiden form?
We hope as little as possible. She says income tax form will match her with the $5,000, Richard.
The ESP went with the audience. Maiden form.
Oh, maiden form.
I'm sorry, darling.
Aw. Well, Kathy, you've enriched yourself a little bit. You're up to $600, and you're going to meet another player now.
Get ready to match the stars. Dick Gautier, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Della Reese, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rammer.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us here. Come over here and let's say hello to our celebrities. I greet you one and all. I would like you to note that the threesome is reunited again. Gautier, so Reilly, and Rayburn. Yeah. Again. Listen, we haven't seen you in a long time. What have you been up to?
Oh, it's only been a couple. Only features. I'm only doing features now. And yeah, I
oh,
did
really?
A couple of movies. Yeah.
No kidding.
Listen, I don't want to be blatant about it because I don't believe people are on these shows to do plugs, Gene. I really think that people are only here to help contestants win and that sort of thing.
Billy Jack goes to Washington. Really?
Try and be a little less obvious.
What do you say we lay hello to champ Kathy Whitehead?
Great.
How are you?
Really good.
Good. Now, as time expired, Kathy won 100. No, you're happy about that. Let's welcome Joseph May. There's Joseph May. Now, you can get back up there so we can stop. Joseph, you know Kathy Whitehead there? And she's up to $600, which isn't bad at all. Joseph, we welcome you and ask you to tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm from Mount Carmel, Pennsylvania. I'm married. My wife's name is Gretchen. We're both hairstylists, and we have our own shop in Pennsylvania.
In Pennsylvania somewhere. Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, the best of luck to you. Who does your hair?
Myself and my wife.
Oh, I see.
I comb it in the morning, and she does it.
I see. All right. Well, we'll start this game in a moment or so, but right now we want to start a little message for you. Pay attention, then come right back. Here we go. Boing. Joseph May, you may have A or B.
B, please.
B it is. We're going to start this game right now. And are you ready to begin?
I am ready to begin.
Thank you, my dear. Ugly Edna said.
She's my favorite.
She said, if you think I'm ugly now, you should have seen me before I had my plastic surgery. Then I looked like blank. That's what Ugly Edna said. If you think I'm ugly now, you should have seen me before I had my plastic surgery. Then I looked like blank. We're going to see a lot of you on Chico and the Man.
I hope you're going to see a lot of me on Chico and the Man.
Yeah, well, we'll keep watching for you.
I'll keep being over there so you can see me, too.
Okay, good. All right, Charles is just about ready, so I'll walk over here to Mr. May and ask him to respond.
Bon voyage.
Bon voyage is one that you want. All right, let's find out if there's the one Richard gave you. Let's begin down at the bottom. As we usually do, and we'll reveal the $100 response. Bonfire.
Oh. Where were you when I needed you?
Let's see if Bon Voyage is under the $250 number.
Oh.
Bonbons. All right, that's the one that Breck gave you, right? No.
Yeah.
No,
yeah,
no one gave you that.
Bon.
Yeah, that's right. Okay.
Bon
sweet
teller.
Little girl that she is.
We're looking for, what did you say you want?
Bon voyage.
Yeah. Bon voyage.
We're on match game.
Roger.
And it's the afternoon.
Roger,
you shouldn't have circled Bon Bon because it confuses me, you see. What she really wanted was Bon voyage there. But I understand it now. You don't understand it. I just wanted you to understand it, Roger.
That's wrong.
Okay. He has a master's degree in...
Not stupidity.
In cue cards.
Okay. In ignorance.
And here we go. Last chance for Bon Voyage. May we see the $500 number?
Yeah.
Yes, congratulations. You got it. Don't jump around too much there. Are you allowed to jump?
Yes.
Oh, you can. Oh. I got a little nervous there. I said, are you allowed to jump? And she said, yes, she's allowed to jump. Don't mind a thing. She just won $500. That's why she's jumping around like that. Okay. Now, Kathy, you're going to play for 10 times of $500 or $5,000. But to collect that amount of money, you must match one of the celebrities exactly. Which one will it be?